right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Tallman, the CEO of Klondike Gold. And Peter, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
I am excited. I am really, really thrilled to be here.
I can imagine. You know, I've gotten to know you quite well. And the one thing I know about you is you love the Klondike and you love everything about it. And to be the person responsible for the first ever mineral resource from the Klondike, I know makes you very, very proud, first off, and secondly, very excited about what's ahead. So just give me some overall thoughts on getting this mineral resource done.
Well, it's amazing, really. 125 years after the discovery of gold, here we are with the first ever mineral resource in bedrock. So 20 million ounces of gold has come from, you know, people have kicked it over with their feet and put it in pans and taken it away. And 125 years later, we've actually documented gold in the bedrock for the first time. And that's a huge milestone, and it's truly decades overdue.
So let's talk about this initial mineral resource. I know you were shooting for somewhere around 500,000 to begin with. So tell me what you were able to come up with as far as the measured and indicated.
Well, just before that, I mean, we're looking for 500,000 to 1 million ounces, and something, a minimum, something to prove to the world there actually was gold in the bedrock here, because for 125 years, there were questions about it. And that always seemed crazy to me. So we were trying to find a mineral resource of one sort. I knew I would come to regret telling our investors, shareholders, that we were going to do one, because as soon as you do, then you have to go do it. But here we are. And it was between 500,000 to 1 million ounces. We got basically 600,000 ounces, half a million indicated, 100,000 inferred, pit constrained mineral resources. The pit constraint is the detail there.
Yeah, and we should mention this is coming from just two parts that we've talked about in the past, Lone Star and Standard. So, and each of those is very different in this mineral resource as well.
Yeah, and it might as well call it chalk and cheese. I agree. Lone Star was, we have two deposits now. So think of this, we've gone from zero mineralization bedrock. Now we have mineral resources and we have two deposits. The Lone Star deposit is responsible for this mineral, from this mineral resource, for 7/8 of the entirety of it. And we only got the Standard Zone, or the Standard deposit now, is 1/8 of it. And so the Standard Zone is, you know, relatively unimportant to the numbers. But what is important are the gold grades. The gold grades at Lone Star average in the indicated 0.64 grams gold. Standard Zone is 50% higher than that at a gram. And I've said this in interviews with you and to our investors and shareholders. It's like the Lone Star is not necessarily the best. It's the first, certainly not the best. Standard is better. And I would contend that we have found other things since Standard now that are better than it. And what we're doing is evolving our mineral resource.
And Peter, is that the questions you're getting right off the bat from people, is about gold grades?
Actually, surprisingly, no. That's my worry. So these gold grades, all of the resources that we have are pit constrained. So what we lost in the entirety of it was another over 200,000 ounces that are just adjacent to the open pits that we modeled. So only resources, gold mineralization ounces that could go within a pit are what we're announcing today. So there is considerable mineralization beyond the edges of these pits that is not included yet. It exists. We just have to do a little more work to basically transfer them from a mineralization category into something that's indicated or inferred.
And is that sort of the next steps now? Tell me what happens now that this is out. What are the next steps that you want to do?
Well, I'm in the weird position of thinking that this is all backwards looking anyway. And so we have this extra mineralization that didn't get included in this mineral, in this particular mineral resource. And we've also drilled all of 2022, and for which we don't have assays yet, but 2022 drilling drilled the Standard Zone. And there's a long length of the standard zone. If you look at one of our maps, it shows there's at least a half a kilometer gap between two little pits that comprise 1/8 of this resource. And I'm confident that we hit basically all the way through what we drilled on the standard zone. And so already with what we have in the hopper, I think we're, well, that prospectively, that's where we go to get 1 million ounces. The next step for us is 1 million ounce plus, and we have a really good start on it already without doing any further work.
All right, we'll leave it there. Peter, congratulations on this. I know it's been a lot of work to get to this point, but it's here and more to come. So good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Peter Tallman, the CEO of Klondike Gold.